Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, you might have seen some of my travel videos or some lifestyle videos here and there, but I'm looking to amp up my YouTube game and post a lot more on here, and I've always wanted to do the favorites videos, and I've always just enjoyed watching these kind of videos from other YouTubers, so hopefully you'll enjoy it on my channel, and I'm excited to get into it. I've got a lot of stuff here. We got some beauty, food, books. Yeah, just like a nice mix of things. I'm gonna share my favorite podcasts, clothes, all kinds of different things. It's just gonna be an all-encompassing favorites video every single month. So hopefully I'll be able to stick to it. And I'm excited to show you what we got. So let's do this. First up, food, because we all know food conquers all the topics that I'm going to discuss today. And this is my favorite after dinner snack. It's the dairy-free mango pineapple sorbet from Fiasco. And I just love this as just a little bit of sweetness after a meal. You don't want to jump off the cliff, but you just need that little hit of sugar. And yeah, this stuff is delicious. My next favorite is still in the food category and still dessert and still ice cream, because I love ice cream. When we were in Hawaii, we had strawberry mochi ice cream and I was hooked. So when I did a little road trip over across the border to Trader Joe's, I found this one and it is so yummy. It's just like a little tiny little crate, so you just pop one out. Just like a nice little delight after dinner. So good. Books. I love books so much. They just fill my soul. Anytime I'm feeling uninspired or just kind of in a slump, or really just something to kind of read before bedtime, I love books. I like listening to podcasts, but I like reading books. I know a lot of people do audiobooks, but I just can't do the audiobooks. I love to read, and my girlfriend Sarah recommended this one to me, and it's called Nothing to Prove: Why We Can Stop Trying So Hard. And I just want to read the inside of this. I love what she wrote. Too many of us have bought into the lie that our cravings will be satisfied if we are enough and if we have enough. So we chase image, answers, things, and people, and we wonder all the while, why am I still thirsty? My single goal with this book is to lead your thirsty soul to the only source of lasting fulfillment, Jesus. He is the living water, a limitless supply that will not only quench your thirst, but will fill you and then come pouring out of you into a thirsty world. Because of him, you are loved, you are known, you can take a deep breath, because you have nothing to prove. So if you are a person of faith and are just looking for a good book to navigate through all of this social media craziness, I definitely would recommend this. I'm loving it so far, and yeah, I'm just getting a lot of peace and new insight, and just being able to look at everything in the world around us that we live in with fresh eyes. And I think it's always great just to kind of get another perspective. Okay, now we are going to talk about some beauty products. I always love discovering new things and what works for others, and I'm excited to show you what I have here today. So I did a tutorial when I was in Turks and Caicos, kind of, you know, easing myself into the whole tutorial world, and this has still been my favorite. It's from Tarte. It's the Amazonian Clay Airbrush Foundation, and it's powder, and I recently just switched over to powder foundation over liquid because I was breaking out a lot from liquid. I just felt like it was setting into my lines and all that kind of stuff. So I've been loving this, and I just feel like it just gives you such a more natural complexion, and it does a great job still with coverage. I felt like powder was just not going to be good for coverage. I really like full coverage, but this one is totally buildable, and I use this brush. I guess there's no number or name on it, but it's just like their Tarte Kabuki brush. So I literally just swirl right in there, and I just kind of buff it in until I get the coverage that I'm looking for. So love this, and love that it's more on the natural side too. The next thing I've been loving is the Charlotte Tilbury Supermodel Body. And this is a really awesome roll-on shimmer, like moisturizer. I love just kind of rolling it on my skin here when I have like off the shoulder tops, or I've got like an event or a wedding or something like that, and you kind of just want to be a little bit extra glowy. This stuff is amazing, and it doesn't even leave like residue or like that self-tanner kind of look on your fingers. It's really natural, and it just gives you just like a soft, you know, sun-kissed glow. So I'm always about that. So this is amazing. Love this. Next up, I share this in my blog post for my evening skincare routine, and this is from Sunday Riley, and it's their Tidal Brightening Enzyme Water Cream Moisturizer, and I have just been loving this. My skin is pretty dehydrated, so I need moisture, but I will break out if I use the wrong kind of cream. So this has been really nice. It's water-based and it just totally soaks into my skin. It's been a great base even for makeup, for evening. It is on the pricey side, but if you're looking for something just to kind of use at nighttime, you don't need too much, and a little goes a long way. Love it. Another beauty product I have here is this YSL blush. I'm a huge blush girl, and this one is Heart of Light Powder Blush number 3. And I love YSL just for their packaging. It's so pretty and beautiful, but their blushes are really extraordinary. I'm wearing it today. We filmed a little tutorial for my wedding makeup, so you can catch how we use that in there. So the last beauty product I have is the Retinol Reform by Shawnee Darden, and it's just this nice safe retinol that you can use every single night, and I just like using it for any dark spots or scarring. I have been loving this product. This, I guess, would go into the hygiene category because it's toothpaste, and I don't know if that would fit into beauty or what, but this is coconut oil toothpaste, coconut banana, and it has organic chamomile, flower, and coconut oil. And I like to do oil pulling, which is basically just swirling coconut oil in your mouth for like 10 to 50 minutes, however long you can, and it just kind of pulls out things in between your teeth, all the dirt, all that fun stuff. So when I saw that they have toothpaste, I was totally all about it, and yeah, it tastes super good. It kind of tastes like almost like kids medicine, coconut banana. I know that's really weird, but I always liked banana medicine when I was a kid. And then next up, I've got two hair care products, both from Target. Target closed down in Canada, so I've gotta go across the border to find all of the stuff that is good in the world, because I just love Target so much. And when I was in Hawaii, I stopped there, and then I did a little road trip driving across the border and found some more goodies. So when I was in Hawaii, I had dyed my hair, so I needed some purple shampoo, and this is amazing because there's no parabens or sulfate and all that stuff. And not only that, I just found that purple shampoos are super drying, and this one has just been really great. I haven't found that it's dried my hair out as much as the other one I was using, and I just love that it has less of the gunk that's in a lot of hair products. So this is awesome. And then this is from Kristen S. I think that's how you say her last name. Lauren Conrad's hair dresser. She also came out with a line in Target, and this is the cleansing conditioner. I also have her hair mask, and I just, to be honest, I kind of gravitated towards this because of the packaging, because I thought it was so pretty. But I'm actually really loving the formula, and it's done a really good job at just recovering my hair, because I've kind of felt that it was getting a bit dried out from like the sun, the hair dye, all that fun stuff. So I finally feel like I've got my formula down with the hair. Okay, now on to clothes. So I picked up this dress for our upcoming cruise, and we're doing Europe. So I thought this was gonna be so cute for Italy. I love the gingham. It's off the shoulder. It's super comfortable and just like airy, but it's such a pretty spring dress that you could get so much use out of. There's pockets, which I love. And you can tie this up in the front as a bow. I styled this on my blog and I'll link everything down below as well as all the other products. And yeah, I just love it. And I was waiting for it to go on sale and it did. And here we are talking about it in the favorites video. Last favorite is a big favorite. And this is the Louis Vuitton Neverfull, and it's the large one. This was a little prezi from my sweet husband, and it was always a bag that I kind of had on my wish list, but I kind of always put off to the side. I thought, okay, it's always gonna be there. It's a very classic style. It's been around for years at LV, but now that I have it, I have not stopped wearing it. It's amazing for travel. Fits everything that I need, and I just love how it goes with everything. Surprisingly goes well with so many things. And what I love about Louis Vuitton leather is it's so durable, such great quality. I can't say that about every single high-end bag that I purchased, but LV has always stayed true. A lot of you guys have been asking what size I got, and I got the large. I personally think that the large is worth it. It just fits everything that I need. I always kind of really like big bags. Everyone calls me a bag lady, so I'll take it. If you don't know, I do some designing, and I have my own print shop, stationery. We do prints, notebooks, note cards, all that fun stuff. And something I recently designed were my own phone cases. So exciting. So these just came out last month, and everyone tagging them on Instagram. I just want to thank you all so much for your support. We did 4 different phone cases, and we have from the iPhone 6 all the way up to the 7 Plus. Unfortunately, it's only just for iPhone users, but who knows, maybe something down the road with Android cases. But I'm an iPhone user, so I'm a little bit biased. And yeah, I just love this one. This one is my favorite. It's the Work It, and I love it because it's got little glasses. It's just nice and neutral, so it kind of goes with everything, and it's not too crazy or loud. But I'm quite proud of this, so it's exciting to see my products always in their packaging. I think it's always just a really cool thing. So alright, so that's the end of the favorites video. I hope you all enjoyed this. Leave me a comment down below letting me know what kind of videos do you want to see on my YouTube channel. I linked everything in the description box. You know the drill. You just click and it'll take you right to the direct product that I'm talking about or blog post that I've mentioned. And I so appreciate you taking the time to watch my videos. So thank you so much, and I will see you soon. Thank you.